Okay, so what I will do today, I will play just 9 games. 9 games is like, it's like you're playing tournament. So, and let's win the tournament. So if 9 game, yeah, we get 7 hype points out of 9, we won't win the tournament. That is good motivation, it's a good way to keep the right mood, yeah?
So we go, on the left I will keep the chat open. Oh, super! You are going to play in Reykjavik ChessMood openings. Super! We're looking forward, Craig, to see your great games. So I will comment and post them if you crush someone very strongly. So let's go, guys. I will change the settings. So I will not play only with strong opponents. It's here. Okay, minus 400, plus 400, save. Okay. Okay, and the show begins. 3 plus 5 minutes and 3 plus 0, let's play also. 3 plus 0 is a little bit tough, no time for commenting. Yeah, by the way, guys, you can see here I raised my yellow. When I play and I don't comment, sometimes they make a challenge for me. Like when I comment and stream, of course, the quality of the games go down, so I just go to 2500. Then I make a challenge for me, I will play until I get 650. And sometimes I make these morning challenges to me. So this was one of them. So I get back 650, yeah? That's three. Okay, let's go three. It's tough times, a bit. It's hard to find opponents. So I will mix this time. And this is not right now 7 a.m. for me. This will be 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. for me. So you can, other people also who is right now sleeping can watch the another stream. Okay, the first game. See, this is put automated. Okay. We go our anti-Sicilian systems. By the way, it's 3 plus 0 or 3 plus 2? 3 plus 0. Okay, cool. Okay, bishop b5 if you remember, the next move or queen e2 and f5. Bishop e7, I remember there is this move, or not. So I can go f5, and I can go b3 as well. Okay, let's play it fast. Okay, I spent too much time for thinking. So if we take, queen f6, I have 95 move. I was thinking between knight e5 move and long castle and taking and then playing knight e5. Oh, it was okay. Let's make some weakness there. So whatever now he does, there is mid weakness. If g6, h4, if f5, e6 will be weak. g6, h4 we go. f5. Okay, now it's good. Now e6 is problematic for him. And he gives this square important.
before. So I think it's okay. Okay, now it's fast, some fast pressure on e6, very fast, it should be here. Okay, it is. The change is good, we will get e-line. Cool. So now e-line is ours. It's very cool. A little bit tempo. Okay, we go to with queen, with king, so we're ready for going to rook endgames, which will be winning for us. Even now, probably we can go. Not really sure. Yeah, it looks like pawn landing is lost for him, which is very important. C4, B5 it goes, and D3 and come back to take the pawn. Oh, yes, King D7 strong move, which I missed. But to kill King D7, this should be strong move for him, and this may be draw. Yeah, he did it. Now he even tricked me to go to A4, so I have to do this. But I will win him by time. Okay, then remove for him. Okay, it will be fight four times. Oops! Stalemate. Oops, King D7, very important move I missed here. One moment, bro. Yeah, very strange here was. This looked like maybe B4 at first I should go. B4, C4, B5. Before even if King D7 I take here. And this should be lost. Yeah, I missed King D7. But later G5 he played very well. Cool one, cool job. Let's go. So we lost here one game. Yeah, okay, where is it? Oops. This one. So okay, I write here the first round we lost. Let's go to the next round. Rematch, let's go. Let's go for rematch. So the rook D1 after knight D4 about. Yeah, knight D5 also was cool. 95 also was okay. Changing the knight, it's better, because when I change the knight, e5 score is totally mine. So it's super cool. Okay, here we play knight f3 in the course. While the main line here is bishop c4. Okay, let's go to e6. I think this is the strongest one. E6, castle, and a6. Bishop d3 here, yeah. And knight c6. D6, b3 here, yeah, was in the course. Okay, this is also possible for white, but this is okay, case enough for us. White lost many tempos here, d1, bishop f1, this is staying not really aggressive for us. Here the problem of this system, Scheveningen system, is when the rook is on f1 and this go f4, f5, g4 sometimes. This rook e1 system is safe for us, and like more or less safe. Here, I would go here and d5, bishop e6 I put here, using the moment that this bishop is very bad for him. I put queen c7 or c8. Yeah, it looks like we have problem with d5 square. Yeah, but the thing is, our bishop on e6 is doing super job, and he can never change these two bishops. A4. Okay, queen a5 is fine for us. Queen a5, but then knight d5. Sometimes we may leave this move. B6 we can put. So after a5 all the time, we have b5. So with b6 we provide somewhere queen c7, queen b7, good place for our queen. Bishop d3, very strange move. Bishop c4, it looks like we let him to change here, but now we put strong pressure on c2. And again, I'm never letting him to play this knight c5 move. Okay, this is cool, because when I take with pawn, now no more pressure with this c line. And then we go to the another place. So b5 now. Yeah, let's go this. So at the end, if you take queen b5, I will take the c2 pawn. Okay, this is we put here. Just c3. Now we should activate this bishop. Play 1-3-4. Okay, this is free. bad move for him. He killed his bishop himself. Okay, check is here, yeah? Okay, let's get the checks. Oh, 3 plus 0 is too nervous. Let's go play 3 plus 2. Hope someone will play. Right. I will check the chat. Why not f5 to defend the pawn? Why not f5 to defend the pawn? Why not f5 to defend the pawn? Good question. Yeah, right, I could just play bishop d8 f5, yeah? Yeah, right, f5 I could just play. Right. Let's go. Oh yeah, I remember this guy. He played Bengal Gambit with a4. So let's see. I have another trick for him. And see what he plays against g6 line. This is also tricky. I assume it will be a course with more details with g6, bishop g7, and queen a5. I remember this guy's. a7. Yeah, this is one of the strongest moves. This guy knows very well theory. Later he played it very slow, and this I was even thinking that I was not sure if this is real game or he is cheating somehow. But the opening part he knows very well. Later we will outplay him. Yeah, why I play bishop a6? I like to put my queen on a6. This is very important to have queen on a6. So when the queen is on a6, we fight for this d3 square. Now knight b5 is coming. I want to put b7. Not letting knight b5, attacking there. And if b3, we can play queen a6. And if you remember from Mega Gambit, whenever we change the queen, it's our favor. And we will see after changing the queen, knight will go to g4 or knight d7. Oops. Now he has to do something with his queen, because if he'll go somewhere with his queen, he will give this d3 important square. If it let us to change, it's cool, super cool. So, okay, just free pawn. Thank you. We can change also this bishop, but then this bishop gets knights go to c4 very strongly. But we keep this knight because this d5 square, d5 pawn is super super weak for him. So we're gonna attack this pawn. Let me see how. Okay, let's go knight a6. Yeah, so after I take here, I will attack from b4, so this bofield will hang. Yeah, this is an important pawn. Whenever this e4 pawn hangs in Bengal Gambit, then d5 becomes very, very, very weak. Hmm. Okay, we'll play some match with him. So he plays d4, yeah, so it will be live stream about Mega Gambit. So it will be a good example how to put in practice. Bishop f4, we chant this one, and we play knight b4, taking another pawn. Yeah, it's very cool to play Mega Gambit in Blitz. Super cool. So now one of the pawns hang, and it's absolutely bad for him, because if this pawn hang, this will also hang. If this pawn hang, this will hang. And anyway, as soon as we lose this knight, he will take all his pawns. Okay, now hard question, which pawn is important? I prefer this one, because, yeah, this is also okay, but take, and sooner or less he will take also these two. And d5 probably immediately was okay, because you take this f4 pawn, but I don't count this as a pawn, because anywhere sooner or less this is ours. Yeah, and b4. Please protect this pawn, bro. Okay. What you will do if you go to a2, man? Also, we have knight c2, knight d4. Now let's see, do we want to play? Knight f4. We will grab all his pawns now. He will resign soon. People get very nervous when giving all the pawns one by one. Yeah, exactly. Immediately that happened. So, okay, accept here. So now we have 2 pawns out of 3. Okay, Krik, this is for you, so you play French in Reykjavik. Oh, I remember, this is the guy who played bishop b4 line. So now we will fix it and play Chen Ki, and we'll keep the queens. Krik, do you remember? This was the game, this was the opponent about which you asked me a question, what is the right one. He played here knight e5, knight c3, and here he played bishop b4. Okay, a6 this time. Okay, we will go to our knight f3, gf3, interesting line. Which one should I just go task? See, it become a little bit cold, or I'm nervous. And the important part here is that bishop b4, long castle bishop c3 is not working here. Oops, 1 second. Bishop b4, I cannot show bishop b4. Here, bishop b4, long castle, bishop c3, knight e6. I have f5. I messed up. I think Greg, he also played something like this, yeah, against me. So how did I play? Rook g1, yeah? Yeah, rook g1, bishop b7, knight f5, I think I played against you. d4, this is guy prepared. I think this was exactly like I played with you, right, Greg? c8, strange move. Okay, you want to take here on f3. Just rook d2, man. And all I see is light. pawn, that will take knight g7, you take, yeah, you take g7. The knight c5 we will have, so we will close this line. Yeah, yeah, Kevin, exactly, it's really funny. Usually when you have a piece down, yeah, you try to keep the pieces, yeah? But in our case, we changed the queens ourselves. And in the course, I explained these things, why it's happened. Because queen is protecting the a2 and b3 pawns very well, our opponent queen. And also the d3 important square. So when we change the... Okay, he took it. Really, man? This works? Queen d1. This may be a very nice game. Now it looks like we want to play rook e1, but knight c5 is very unpleasant for him as well. Because after rook e1, what he will do, he will give this knight d4, he will give his piece. Knight c5 looks interesting also, because knight c5 he cannot take it, because rook d8 checkmate. So... it's hard for me to find a good move now for him. Okay, I missed bishop d6 move. Bishop h6, sorry. Position is still very interesting, or not? Okay, let's fight. Let's fight. Okay, I think we can take. Yeah, bishop h6, a very unpleasant blunder I made. Should try to somehow to make problems for his king. Queen b5. Check from here. c6 he want to play. Bishop d8. Take queen e1, rook e1. Yeah, let's take this one. Let's queen f1, I rook e1. Here, okay, I'm okay with changing the queens. My 2 points will be good.
to push his pawns. I think he don't want to make the draw, but he wants. Strange. Like I fight always so no draws. Strange, he still wants to make a draw. A very strange guy. Okay, draw. Oh, not draw? Fine, cool, finally you fight. Okay, he agreed to draw. One more guy, you play Banco Gambit, so we are okay to play with you. Okay, now another Banco Gambit we will play, so I play different reductions. Okay, here instead of knight bd7, there is interesting queen b6. What's the point? After a4, I keep my knight on b8. So it will go knight a6, knight c7. This is a very interesting, tricky move, queen b6. And it's in our plans. Now we will put our queen on b7. And now, okay, knight d2. Queen a6 we can play. But what was the right answer here? Okay, it was 26. Thinking about queen d3, but it allows him to play rook e1, rook e3. So my queen on d4 may be trapped. So okay, I will come to play knight b5. Good thing after knight b5 he cannot play knight c4 because e4 pawn is hanging. And after knight b5, what will be our plan? We'll play queen b7, knight d8, knight c7. So knight d2, his knight is not placed well, because what is usually his plan when he played a4 line is to place our knight b5 and bishop d2, bishop c3. But with knight on d3 we have some problems with doing this, so now he should at first protect this. With rook e1 now probably, yeah? Rook e1. But rook e1 also, I'm thinking about knight b6, knight b6, knight a4 to take the pawn. Does he want to play b3, yeah? Okay, I'm okay if you play b3 now. So b3 will keep this rook here very nicely. Okay, good, he did it. What then? Let's not allow bishop b2 move, and let's change this one knight. This one to his. Now our target is this b3 pawn. After changing a few pieces, rook b8 will come and we put pressure on b3 pawn. f3. Another strange move.
we change few pieces, and our position becomes better in almost all the time in Mago Gambit. But most of the things is because due to these two super rooks, two half open lines, and both we make pressure. So a5, very dangerous move for him. He may lose his pawn. Now we have knight d7, we have knight c8. Also, I check knight d5, queen b7, knight d3 check, king f2, and I don't see anything there. Okay, so knight d7 or knight c8. You want to play a later knight c4 move after changing it. So it would be cool if it also could manage to change this knight. So if we want to manage to change this knight, let's put it here. So after change knight c4, we will have knight e5. We have knight b6 then. Now to change this knight. Okay, first we put rook b5. Or rook a6. Knight e5, I'm not sure about a6 move. But a6 is high. Okay, knight e5. A6, we can play rook a7. Okay, change now. Okay. Now we play our b1, b4. Okay, let's go our typical move. Yes, somehow he got some advantage, but it's still very hard for him because b1, b4, we will just play b5 and stop it exactly there. Rook e1. A6 is okay, rook a7 is protecting there. D6, e6, he won't, okay. No worry. We have bishop f6. Bishop e5 also wants our to play. Bishop g5 check still he has. Okay, rook a8, we just play and take the pawn. Now his pawns are hard to keep. I don't see how he can do that. Just not bishop e5 to not blunder this rook e5 move. Okay, we don't blunder it, but we blunder with d3 move. Check for him, but make his king on h3. Good. Okay, this is interesting. We have lots of chance to win this with 3 against 2 when his king is on h3. I think I give this pawn. Now give the rook. Back. And just not to make stalemate with h2 king h3. What was the easy way to win this? Make a move until they sink. Can be a trade pilots. Check. And now no stalemate. Or there is rook h3 stalemate. I wanted to play h2, king h1, king h3, but then he has rook a3. Okay. Not rook a3. Oops, I already. Let's put our pawn on g3. We are playing like cat and mouse with him. Now why didn't we play king g4? Where, Kevin? Where king g4 in the rook endgame? Where? Okay, so how we won him, and then we made the draw, then we won him. So now we have a 4.5 out of 6. Our goal is 7.5 to win the tournament. So let's play some with someone else as well. 5, okay, 5 we go. 3 plus 2. 3 plus 0. Yeah, h2 pawn was hanging again. Yeah, my rook was on a2, so I could take that h2 pawn. That the rook a2 check was a very important check. Okay, same opening. Okay, let's play. Let's play against him. Something else. Let's play d3 system. About d3 system also, I will make a course.
Okay.
B6 he will play. Yeah, he knows theory very well, this guy. I like how he play. What he's doing, he is waiting for me, and when I go e5, he won't play knight d7, bishop b7, and go long castle. He don't want to go short, because e5, knight f1, h4, these typical attacks are starting, knight h2, knight g4. So he wait for me. While he wait for me, I play c3, a3, and play b4. Interesting idea, there is after a3, when he plays a5, I play a4, and after which I get this b5 square. There is very interesting idea, knight b1, knight a3, and taking this b5 square. Okay, bishop a6. I'm not sure if there was this move in the theory. So the first thing I see, I want to punish him, like queen a4, bishop d3, knight e5. But there I see b5 move. Okay, consider let's play. Look, d8 he want to play, to go to our typical attack e5. Also with knight f1 we prepare bishop f4, and after e5 we will have our idea h4, h5, with h6 we bring our knight on g4. Knight h2, knight g4, and then h6 pawn starting to hang. Yeah, really, oops, Kevin. Rook A2 check was super check. Okay, let's attack. Bishop F4 is staying in this line super. Because very often after H4, knight G5, sometimes we have bishop D5 tactic. Take E6, so queen is hanging because of our bishop on F4. So, bishop F4 is typical very. Okay, by the way, after h6 is strange, but he can play g5 and take d5 pawn. So h4 anywhere in our plans, knight h4, knight g4 now is coming there. Also queen d2 very often unpleasant for him, queen d2 and just take there. Okay, b4 move, usually we meet with c4 move. Let's go with... C4 we try to kill this bishop, and next move b3, and have, and it's very hard for him to do something against this pawn structure. Yeah, now after knight go knight g4, yeah, also knight f6 check sometimes will hang for him. So yeah, now after knight g4 there's the injury tactics may come. Okay, man, we are coming to checkmate you, be ready. Knight d4, but this knight d4 makes our c4 pawn super strong. Checkmate him there. Yeah, I won't and I will checkmate him. protect their man, please. protect your a6 pawn. Mister. Excuse me, if h6, h5, sorry, now knight f6 check I have. Here we go! Okay, he just gave his queen. We have two pieces, two pieces. Okay, we continue attack. Queen g5 with tempo here, and protect from here, and h5, like multifunctional move, thank you. Okay, we won one more, so now we have how many points? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5.5 out of seven. Okay, so three rounds left. Let's go. Okay guys, so will you let me to play Modern Benoni 4-1-1 game? I want to see what he played in this time. He has very strong preparation, and anyway, Modern Benoni is one of the courses that soon will come. So I will offer you to play both Banco Gambit and Modern Benoni. This Modern Benoni is very tricky and very aggressive one, and super easy to win weaker opponents. Bishop f4 line he go. A6 is important move in this line. A6 we include a6 a4, and then we go to Bishop g7. So not letting their queen a4 check, knight b5, many moves. Okay, there is typically queen e7, knight bd7 idea, but there is my preparation is rook e8, knight bd7. Knight bd7, knight e5, the thing is that after knight bd7, bishop d6, knight b6 I have. And with rook e8 I want to play knight e4. And in these lines it's very important to change one knight. If we change one knight, almost all the time we have super position. Because this is a TV concept, bishop is doing well, but knight is closing him. So with this, we open one, and then we have also space disadvantage, right? Because of this d5 pawn. So changing a few pieces is in our favor. Knight d2 here is a theory. Knight d2, rook b4, knight c4. And there is nice knight before knight c4, I think knight d7 is the move, or b5 even. Rook f4 is also there is possible, rook f4, bishop b2. Let me remember this stuff. I think b4 was right, and after knight c4 I think knight d7 was the right move. Okay, just this. Take pawn. Okay, I think too much already. Now time to make some move. take this one and see them. Good afternoon, knight c4, rook b4, he cannot take this pawn with not bishop, not knight. If bishop d6, rook c4. If knight d6, rook f4. Knight c8, usually I will go with rook somewhere. And then this knight on c8 will be trapped. Rook b1. Okay, we'll do a strange move at first glance, a5. So now if you take, I take there, if you take this, I take there. If you take here, I take here and my rook plays. Yeah, Bobby, just take practice and just you do it a lot. Anything you do it many times, you become master of this. So you play, you practice, and then one day you also do the same. Yeah, this was I was speaking that after rook b4, his knight will be trapped. Yeah, and this exactly happened. Okay, Greg, I was asking if he will allow me or not. If not, okay, I will play only chess mode openings. But sometimes, like, you know, it's like from 9 games, I think it's okay. 2 games to play something that anyway, sooner or less, I will make a course. Now let's see which one is more important. It seems to me this one. Not let him to play knight e7 check. Now it not just need to block a good way with this pawn and it will be finished. Queen d7 looks good to totally block this. Or knight d7. Let's knight d7. So we block, we protect the 5 pawn. Now we bring our pieces. Rook should come from here. So grab this pawn. And I've been holding back the tears, dreaming of these years. And I'll sing from the heart if you listen to me. Everything I do is what I believe. This 7 you want to put? Give you or something.
let's see how we can win this position. Myself, I don't know how. But we will try to find a way. Okay, so one more point. Now we go to the last one. Okay, Greg, this is for you. French in practice. Okay, last time I knight f3, I took gf3, and in the course I said that knight f3 is also interesting, knight f3 bishop d4. So this time let's play this. So we have difference there. Knight f3 bishop d4, so we close this line and we can go to long castle. This is good, he let us immediately to go long castle. It's okay, right now we have 94 also, but 94 also okay. Okay, unfortunately it seems not working. I couldn't find anything serious. It looked like very dangerous for him, but couldn't find what could I do. So playing g5. I wanted to take g5, take king b1, bishop f8, and play something like knight d7, bishop d4, knight f8. But he can just give this gives that exchange and it's okay for him. Queen a4. B3 is okay for us. And b6 he wants to take here, yeah? But he also not dangerous for us. And b6 with d8 also, yes. Okay, let's just b3.
I never knew I could feel so low. you say Samar plays g5 and I go knight g4. I'm gonna have 6 check, knight h6 check. So we will make this work. This bishop and rook. My biggest concern now is knight d5, queen h2 and f6 move. But still there are some ideas with g5. Because my h3 is 6 pawn main here. Okay, but knight for d5, queen h3, I cannot play knight f4, knight d2 is coming. Unpleasant moment. Very unpleasant moment, so queen should come to g3 in other place. No, H4 is not playing bishop f4. Now what is also important when you feel that okay something is going wrong and come back your pieces and try to protect your king and start to defend it also good skill. And d3 I'm playing at c5 to close this rook. And open my bishop. And also f4 I want to go. Let's see what you want. I want to sacrifice it. I was afraid from queen c6 more, but at 95 I have successful. Okay. There's magic in the air. I can feel it everywhere. Okay, cool. Now there is some composition, but probably not enough. This game also from the opening I was not really fine. Somewhere here. Maybe g4 immediately I should go, g4, g5 immediately. But okay, there was two interesting games with this French line. Which now after I finish the stream and I take a very fast breakfast, I will make a record about these two games because this is important for our course of French. So I will record and I will add in the pro section for advanced courses. I will analyze these two games and see where I could improve, where I could play in a better way. Yeah, and also it was interesting stream because we had some interesting games with Bango Gambit. So you saw in the practice how to put, how to change the queens. And in French also we had very interesting games. The result was, yeah, we made our goal. 7.5 out of 9. Anyone who joined us a bit later, this is one of the good tips I offer you to keep the right mood, yeah? You make a goal to win the tournament. Like, imagine that you are playing 9 round tournaments, and for winning the tournament, usually 7.5 points is enough, right? So, in order to keep this motivation, like, because very often you can lose first game, second game, and then you, okay, you don't want to play anymore, yeah? But when you remember this is tournament, so you have to play 9 games and then finish your session, this is keeping your right mood as right as possible. Your mood is keeping as right as possible. It was interesting, 7.5 points, so we made our goal, so we won the tournament, let's say, the tournament that we imagine in our head. Also, another tip I offer you, to make reward for you. So you sit to play, you come to right mode and you say, okay, I will play and I will win it, yeah, I will play good games, yeah? And if you manage, this is your goal, yeah? You manage it, reward yourself something. Your doctor say don't eat ice cream, you reward yourself. So if you get this, you reward yourself and get ice cream, or you invite your wife to the dinner, which I will make soon. Okay, so I will check the question in the chat. Yes, this guy, I was not sure he was cheating or not, but whatever happened, I got, like, every time I make session, every time I stream here, the next game day, I got minimum 10 points, hello back from chess.com telling me that one of your opponents was cheating against you. So people like to cheat against Grandmaster. I don't understand this stuff. All the time I speak about it, they want to win Grandmaster or what, but they cheat against Grandmaster much more than others. So opening this man no openings very well. So I'm not sure about his cheating in the first part. Maybe he's playing opening part with his chess base and then playing himself. By the way, guys, I think in chess.com there is a function when you can check all my games. So accelerated dragon games you can also check there. And what I will do, all the games that are interesting, I save them in my database. So later I will analyze, record that interesting games, which is about our ChessMood courses, and upload in the courses section. So okay, today we finished the stream, so if you have any questions, guys, I am here. Okay, guys, thank you everyone who was with us and supporting me. So it's another feeling when you play and some people support you and want you to win. Thank you everyone, thank you for being here. See you during the next streams. I will upload in the events section, probably next week we will have a lot. And guys, don't remember our new members, tomorrow we have 101 calls, so reserve your seat if we have not yet any 101 call with you. So, GM Avedik was with you guys, take care. I see the last questions here. Why do you recommend Accelerated Dragon and not Classical Dragon? Classical Dragon is very dangerous, especially if you check it with server engines with 100,000 KNS. There is very, very dangerous, so you can get immediately checkmate without doing any move. Yeah, if someone's prepared very strongly, it's very, very dangerous. In Accelerated Dragon, especially with the Rook E8 line, which is very, very trendy, we don't get checkmate like this. it's not so complicated. And why I recommend Accelerated Dragon, this is also very, very big variation, very big line. But the Accelerated Dragon Rook E8 line, it's cut big theory. So instead of Rook E8, there is Queen A6, move D6, A5, which everyone was played more than 1,000 games, yeah? Move Rook E8 is just cutting, it's just 100-200 games. And it's very new, trendy, especially I hope in streams we will use this. It's like when you play stream, when I play this, player spent 1 second for each move, yeah? And then you play Rook E8 and then starting to sink, 10 seconds, 20 seconds, yeah? And this happened also in the classical games. So because of this Rook E8, and it's less dangerous than Dragon.